Medical achievements in today's world went beyond all borders. With the utilization of new technology that King Faisal Specialist Hospital and Research Center provides, our healthcare team is able to observe and assist patients at all regions in the kingdom. One of the leading services provided by Health Outreach Department is the eHealth Center, which was recognized by the World Health Organization as a collaborating center on eHealth. Tele-ICUs help improve the outcomes and quality of care and reduce waiting time and bed utilization at King Faisal Specialist Hospital and Research Center. It also improves services at remote hospitals. Moreover, it provides lectures and training for medical staff in the different regions. Furthermore, the service of health outreach for international and national medical second opinion made an impact on patients' convenience by minimizing traveling abroad to get the treatment they need and receive medical second opinion at a reasonable time.
We are proud that the eHealth Center at King Faisal Specialist Hospital is one of the three centers in the world recognized by WHO. This recognition came after a continuous effort and support from our management. Back to the history, it was 1996 when we established the first telemedicine between King Faisal Specialist Hospital in Riyadh and hospital and university in the United States. From that experience, we learned a lot, and we established our national telemedicine. At that time, we were utilizing the satellite, and subsequently, the technology advanced, and we are utilizing fiber optic. With this technology, it gives us more reliable, more stable, and with this great infrastructure, we are able to launch e-health application and services that benefit patient, physician, nurses, and health alike. With all this success, it was an excellent partnership between Ministry of Health as well as King Faisal. I am sure that if we continue to have the same momentum of this collaboration and partnership, we are going to launch more successful story and more advancement in a form of e-health, m-health, and the rest of advancement in technology.
Good morning, Dr. Vivek. I heard you have interesting case that we need to get some opinion, and also the family request second opinion.
Right, yes, sir. We actually discussed this case last Wednesday with Dr. Hosseini. We just want to catch up, follow up on this patient again.
So we can actually ask one of the respiratory therapists to join us now.
Respiratory care services are an integral part of the tele-ICU team. Many regional hospitals don't have respiratory care services. The tele-ICU brings a diverse range of expertise and knowledge to patients all over the kingdom. Every day, we discuss patients that are critical, receiving mechanical ventilation, non-invasive ventilation, and other respiratory care modalities. We give our recommendations, knowledge, and we give demonstration to healthcare providers about modalities that they could do to their patients. This way, we ensure quality and safe patient care, both internal to this hospital and to patients who are all over the kingdom.
This program is providing us with a communication tool between King Faisal Specialist Hospital consultants and the intensivists from the referring hospitals throughout Saudi Arabia.
We have relationships with world-leading institutions such as Johns Hopkins, Mayo Clinic, Cleveland Clinic, and Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center in New York. The medical second opinions are paper-based or live face-to-face video conferences or an audio conference between physicians. Occasionally, family members will attend. The International Medical Second Opinion program utilizes lean principles in resource utilization. for every real that is spent doing a medical second opinion, we're saving over 50 reals versus sending the patient abroad.
We are introducing a new clinical service through telemedicine consults for arrhythmias. We hope that this will be of great benefit to our patients because they currently come from all over the kingdom traveling great distances. We expect to be able to help our peripheral hospitals in managing complex patients who are critically ill and cannot travel and have arrhythmias. We also hope to provide consult services while patients are still in their hometown.
We have so far about 22 tele-ICU services where the King Faisal people provide, or King Faisal specialized doctor in the ICU provide their medical services to the patients in their hospitals, in the regional hospitals. This service, which is tele-ICU, we are very proud of it. It started in 2008 with two centers. And alhamdulillah, so far we have 22 centers connected with the King Faisal Hospital in Riyadh, where the hospital will provide them with tele-ICU services. The patient stay in their hospital and our staff here communicate by video conferences and provide them with the care they need. And this service really, it has very good impact on the patient, where their satisfaction were very high by avoiding traveling to Riyadh. Also, we have the health outreach department. It has an offices in 22 hospitals all over the kingdom. These offices provide lab requests, provide medication for the patients, and provide also educational sessions where the staff in King Faisal might give an educational sessions to their colleagues in the regional hospitals through communication by telemedicine or by video conferences. So in conclusion, we are very proud with the outreach services in the hospital. We hope that in the future it will expand, and I hope this will be helpful to our patient and avoid them coming to Riyadh or even traveling abroad.